Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In the previous tutorial, we have learned how to create a full screen video background, and we have created a play and pause option with the aid of HTML5 video tag. But now in this video, we are going to create a button like this. Here it is. And if we click on this button, we can see that the video has been paused and the inner text of this button is now changed into play now option. And if we click here again, it will be converting into a pause here option and the video will be played. That means we are going to implement some sort of JavaScript into this project. Inside this video tag, we are going to delete this controls part. We don't need any kind of inbuilt function of the video tag of HTML5 that we have used. So that is why we are going to delete it, and let's get back to our project and reload and see that it is not in action. So as we can see here that this thing is now off, it is not working. Now all we need to do, we need to create this particular div element at the bottom of our page, which will be residing into a fixed position, and then we need to create this button option. So that is why let's get back to our project, and here we are creating another div. Now we are copying some paragraphs over here. As we can see, this is the paragraph that I copied and pasted in. So we have created a div element with a class name of paraholder, and it is containing an h1 tag and a p tag with some contents inside it. There it goes. And then all we are going to do, we are going to create a button element. So we are naming it as. Now we need to make some more modification to this button. And we will be needing an onClick option. So let's keep it empty. And first of all, let's check what is happening over here. So this div won't be visible as we made this position into a fixed condition. So if we press Ctrl Shift M and get back to our project, we can see that at 320 by 480 pixels resolution, it is now displaying to some extent of this inner div element that we have placed at the bottom of this video tag. But as it is in a fixed condition, we are repeating it again and again. As we have placed this div into a fixed position, so that is why this div won't be visible unless we make some amendment onto it, and that is what we are going to do. Now we are going to copy this para holder from here, and we are coming back to fullpagevideo.css, and here we are going to paste it. Reload, and we can see that this thing is being appearing over here. Hello world. No problem with it. If we press Ctrl Shift M, we can see that this thing is also appearing over here. Still, there's no problem. Some minor modifications. Remember the alpha transparency mode. So all we are doing here, we have created a background with an RGBA, that means the alpha opacity channel. Now, if we just get back and reload, we are sorry, we have made a mistake. It is RBGA, not RGBA. So here it is. Now reload, and there it goes. Now we have to make some minor modifications over here. So we are getting back, and here reload, and we can see here it is. Now let's modify this pause here button. Display should be block, and And here it goes. Now we can see that the button has been presented at the middle of the page, at the middle of this thing. And if we press Ctrl Shift M, we can still see that it is now moving at the middle of this page. Now let's create this particular JavaScript. So we are providing here script. All we need to do, we need to create some variables such as to store this video inside this particular variable. So all we need to do, what we'll be needing here, we'll be needing here this particular ID that we have created. There it goes. Value of this button that we have created with an ID of button. So this is what we are going to do. There it goes. Now in this segment we have created these variables over here, and right now we are going to create a function. But before that we have to amend a mistake that we have made in our previous situation. Here we have created an extra div, and I think I am going to delete off this closing div over here. So we are deleting this closing div tag. Okay, now let's get back into action. Now we are going to create a function. Here it is, button action. So we have created a function known as button action. We have created this variable where we have stored the value against this ID video sample. So we are first checking here whether this stored video, it is actually in paused or not. If it is paused, first of all let's build it up. What will be the inner HTML structure? So this is what it is going to point. We are instructing the JavaScript media to play this particular video over here, and on the other hand we are instructing that the inner text of this button store, that means this ID which has an ID of button, here it is. So this button will be having a text written as pause video, and in the else condition when the video is being played we have to pause it. In that particular situation, on clicking this video will be paused, and the button store variable, that means this button store variable, will be executing a play video text inside it. And we are now copying this function from here and we are pasting it into this on click event handler. So there it goes. So in the first case we will be now reloading our page and we will be observing whether it is working or not. Now we can see that it is not working. So what is the main problem? Get to the URL address bar, copy this particular URL address and get back to Google Chrome, paste it and load it, press F12. Now click on to this pause here button. You can see that here a message is generated stating that uncaught type error. It is now showing you an error over here, and this is the uncaught type error. So why is this uncaught type error? Move into here, we can see that this store underscore video dot post, this is practically showing you this problem. It is not executing the proper video, it is not returning you the proper video. So what amendment should be done over here such that this kind of error can be avoided? Let's get back to our project, and here this is where the conflict of JavaScript will arise. Now this perhaps may seem to you a little bit of confusing, but this is a very obvious thing. This can happen at any time. Whenever the page is being loaded, the first thing that should be rendered into your page is the video upon which all these things are based on. So all we need to do, we need to place this script tag, cut this thing from here. We don't need to appear this script tag, to run this script tag into this head part. All we are doing now, we are placing this script tag and all of these contents inside it right above this body tag, we have placed this particular script code here into this body tag. And now if we get back into our project, and we can see that it is now in action. And if you get back into Google Chrome and reload and click here, you can see that nothing is being generated. In this particular case, the page demands that this video tag should be rendered in the first case, and then only after that all this script tag, all those things will be coming into action. That is why you need to render this video tag first and then you need to run this script. So this is the thing. Now if you get back here, you can see that on clicking this play video button, you can see that this video is in action. On clicking this pause video button, you can see that this video has been paused. So this is the thing that you need to know from this tutorial. Hope you guys have liked this tutorial. If you guys have liked this tutorial, then do not hesitate to hit that red subscribe button down below. Hope to see you guys in our next tutorial. Till then, bye.